insane, nicer than we have in our house.
Just gonna point that out.
What is going on? What is going on? Take your time, take your time, take your time. What? Holy smokes! How big is this fish?
Big! It's really big! Oh my.
It is the middle of May. I'm back in Kenora and it is the long weekend. This vlog is gonna be pretty unique, pretty cool. Today, we're going out on a houseboat. We are with Houseboat Adventures, based out of Kenora. We're downtown, right off the main docks here. And we're taking out the 68-foot houseboat for the weekend. It is their biggest rig. I don't know what to say. I've never been on a boat this big before. We got Jeff, we got Brian, and we got, you know, Sam. What are we doing tonight?
We're gonna head out to Scotty's. We're gonna go out with you for the first half hour or so, and yeah, then I'm gonna let you take it from there.
Perfect. We're going through Devil's Gap, a pretty tight area. So Jeff's gonna show me the ropes. We're gonna get some cool footage going through the gap. I'm gonna give you guys the tour later. Guys, this boat has a top deck. I'm just giddy. I feel like a little kid. Like, I'm on boats a lot, but this is pretty wild. Welcome to Kenora. Welcome to Lake of the Woods. Houseboat Adventures. Here we go. Well, we made it through Devil's Gap, and that was super cool. I think we got some super cool shots. They said I'm gonna drive back on my own at the end of the trip, so hopefully my driving skills are up to snuff. But for now, I'm actually gonna hop off onto the boat, go pick up my parents, and Jeff and Brian are going to keep driving towards our beach for the night. We'll see you in a bit. Absolutely perfect. Look at that beach right there. That is Scotty's beach on Scotty's Island. That is where we're setting up camp. Got my parents. Once we get all camp set up, I'm gonna go pick up Jeremy and Caitlin and Jill and Kyle, my siblings and their partners. So what we're doing right now is we are tying one rope off at a 45 on this side, another one at a 45 on the other side, and that'll stop it from coming in sideways, because that's the biggest problem. Because if this thing gets pushed up sideways, you've got a bit of a situation to deal with. But look at this location. Oh, life is so good. This is incredible. Sam, come here. Come here. We got Scotty's Beach to ourselves. This is like a very popular spot, would you say?
Yeah, very.
Yeah, so the fact that we have it all to ourselves is pretty amazing. Sunset is perfect. Jeremy's gonna end off the day by going for a little dip, and we'll catch you guys in the morning. It is day two. We spent our first night on the houseboat. It was fantastic. We're going fishing. I'm still gonna give you guys a tour yet, but first we're gonna go try to catch some walleyes. Today is opening day on Lake of the Woods. Walleye fishing with the kids. Sam and the parents are gonna stay back, but yeah. We'll come back with dinner. You guys ready? You look bundled. We were starting by jigging some main lake points, trying a little deeper, like 35 feet of water. We are fishing for food today. We're not fishing for big fish. We are trying to get some deep fried walleyes in the houseboat. That's the goal.
You're hobbling off the boat now?
We got one walleye, one bass. Not a success, but I might go back out right away. Family's playing games.
Welcome back to my channel.
Are you rolling?
Today we got Jay Siemens driving the houseboat all by himself. We're gonna play a game today. Who's in the captain's chair? Who's in the captain's chair? It's totally empty. Uh-oh. Let's see here. Who's driving the boat? Here we have Captain Jay Siemens up on top through open waters.
I'm on a boat.
I think you should fist bump the camera or something.
Boo!
Bow, 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 bow.
All right, guys, here's our second little piece of paradise, location number two. Got the boat all towed off, and this is legitimately a house. Like, this is bigger than the cabin that my parents used to rent in Kenora. I'm gonna give you guys a quick little look, quick little tour. This is pretty crazy. I thought they were joking when they told me, but supposedly a helicopter has been landed on top of this thing before. And last but not least, you were able to captain this boat from the top as you saw before. So cool. Yeah, I have never experienced a vessel like this before. We're nearing the end of our first full day, which is crazy. It's flown by. But if we don't get out fishing today, I will see you guys in the morning. Look at that sky. Unreal. And that is another plus of the houseboat. We're so close to a fishing area. Zipped out for the last half hour of the day. Something that I've been told from multiple people is early season Lake of the Woods, you can catch them really deep or really shallow. We got another 20 minutes while we watch the sunset, and hopefully we can get ready for a fish fry for tomorrow.
There we go.
Nice.
Kyle's hooked up. Boat sling him. Boat sling him, Kyle. No! Oh! No! Nice. Mom's got a fish. Wow, we are on him.
Bring him in.
I'm bringing him in.
Oh, sorry.
That one we are gonna eat today.
Jason.
I think I got a little better one actually. I'm actually gonna net this one. Oh, he's barely hooked. Unreal. Guys, we fished like 10 spots this morning and caught one little walleye. And now at the end of the day, we're like, should we go out fishing? Should we not? We decided to come out fishing. We got a live well full of walleyes now. No, they're not big, but these are perfect eating size. Incredible sunset. Fishing with the fam. We're gonna do the cooking part of the catch and cook tomorrow in the houseboat. But for now, we're gonna catch a couple more walleyes. Well guys, it is time to clean these walleyes. We actually got more than I thought. I was worried that we were not gonna have a fish fry this trip, but we got probably like seven, eight walleyes. Gonna quickly fillet them, and then I'm gonna show you guys some new recipes.
You see us rolling, they hating. Something, trying to catch you red and dirty.
Are you rolling?
Yeah.
Guys, we caught some walleyes, nothing big, but perfect eaters. So we are now entering the cooking part of our catch and cook. And this is pretty dialed. There's a boat cleaning station. It's actually like fastened down to the houseboat. We got about 8 walleyes to clean. I'll give you guys a quick rundown on my first one and then we'll power through the rest. But start at the butthole up to the pectoral fins, those guys are called. I'm gonna go beside the gill down till I hit the spine. Turning the knife flat, I can feel it hitting the spine. There's one side, behind the fins, down till I hit the spine. I'm gonna turn that knife flat, I'm gonna feel it just grind against the spine. And you try not to cut through the spine, although it does happen sometimes. There you have the remains. So you don't wanna chuck these in the water, throw them in the bucket, deal with them later. Now we are gonna take the ribs out, put my knife right against the edge of the ribs. I'm turning my knife up at an upward angle. I'm scooping underneath the ribs. You can see there, this is a little bit of a longer fillet knife than I like to use typically, but it's what I had. Ribs are gone. And now last step is I go right to the tail. I leave a little nub so I have something to hold on to. And now I'm just going to grab that nub and I'm not even gonna move the knife much. I'm just gonna shake it with my right hand. Keep that knife flat. And there you go. Cut any thing that shouldn't be there, a little trimming. And then the last piece is right along the middle here. That's called the lateral line, the pin bones. I'm gonna cut on either side of it. And I'm making a little pair of pants. They call this pant legging. Take that little piece out. And there you go. That is a finished walleye fillet. I'm now gonna clean the next 7 and then we will see you guys in the kitchen. Welcome to
Steph Kitchen.
What are we cooking today?
Honey garlic walleyes, which I'm skeptical about, but Jay seems confident in.
Propane gas stove on this houseboat, insane, nicer than we have in our house. Just gonna point that out.
What is going on? What is going on? Take your time. What? Holy smokes!
A big fish!
Okay, take your time. Slow down. Come here.
You take it.
No. Come to the edge.
Oh, I can't.
Okay. How big is this fish?
Big! It's really big! Oh my!
That was a lot of screaming. Ooh, that's a big fish.
I know.
Okay, go over the talon. Oh, that's a big muskie. Take your time.
Oh, I'm
gonna extend the net. Don't put too much pressure on it.
I'm trying not to do anything. I don't know what to do. Lift? No.
Lift.
Oh, we got it!
Yeah! Woo! Woo! Wow!
Unreal!
Wow!
Okay.
Oh!
All right.
Can I just lay it down?
So, we were about to film our cooking session, and Mom just hooked a big old muskie. Muskies are out of season, so unfortunately, we shouldn't even be taking this fish out of the water. We are going to, the jig already popped. We're just gonna let this guy go right now. Grab his tail.
Got his tail.
Yeah.
Just meant, oh.
He's gonna wanna go right away.
Okay.
Yeah, there you go. First muskie for Mom. What do you think?
Oh,
if
oh
she
my
wants
goodness.
To go, you can
shaking.
Let her go.
Okay, here we go. Woo!
How about that?
Yay.
That was insane.
So fun.
I thought somebody was dying in the back of the houseboat. That was ridiculous. I just heard screaming right in the middle of our cooking. What do you think, fam? That gets me so excited for muskie season. Muskies open in 3 weeks. So the key is when you're catching fish out of season, not that you're targeting them, when you catch a fish out of season, the key is to just keep in the water, minimal handling, and that fish swam away very healthy. But that gets me pumped for muskies. Back to the catch and cook now.
I thought that your mama had fallen off the boat because she was screaming.
I picked this area to be closer to good fishing area, and as shown right there, there are big fish in this bay. And I caught a pike earlier off the back of the boat. So, I mean, the whole fam now, I don't know if you can see them, they're all fishing off the boat. But we're gonna get back to cooking in
Sam's kitchen. Our pan is getting warm. We're gonna put in the oil. Tell me how much.
You're the chef. This is your cooking segment. Keep going. That's good.
Okay, next step.
What is that?
This is a mystery. We got our fish, we got our egg wash. We have our super secret, magical...
Tell them what it's called.
Oh, okay. We can use the name?
Yeah.
We have our fish, all right, we have our egg wash, and we have our magical catch and cook batter that we are gonna be using to make our honey garlic walleyes today. Should we double them?
Double dip them for extra crunch?
Yeah.
That's a little trick for you guys back at home. We call it the double dip. All right. Fish are battered. Back to Samantha. How are you gonna test the oil?
This is a trick that Jay taught me. We're gonna take a little bit of the batter and we're just gonna dip it in there to see if it sizzles like that. That's a good sign. So we're keeping the heat pretty high because the more fish we pile in, it's gonna cool the oil down. Oh, look at that sizzle. That's a good dinner bell. I'll do that later. The fish are coming out. I'm just letting the oil dribble through this little thing here. And then we're gonna put it on our paper towel plate. Fish is off, second batch of fish is on, and now we're gonna get on to the next step. I am just small dicing the little garlics right now for our honey garlic walleye. In goes our butter. And then the garlic?
Yep.
So we cook the garlic for a little bit, make it all fragrant and beautiful. And now we're gonna add some honey to it.
Do you want me to toss it?
Yeah. Ooh, you're good.
All right, we are going to take it upstairs to my family.
Okay.
We got, what is
wow.
this called, Sam?
Honey garlic walleye.
Nice.
Guys, that is a wrap on part one of our trip with Houseboat Adventures. If you guys are interested in doing this, which you should be, check out the link below. If you mention this video, you get a 5% discount on 44 and 49 foot boats for week-long and weekday rentals. I don't know what there's to say. For fishermen, for family groups, for bachelor, bachelorette parties, so many reasons that you should check out a houseboat, go on a trip. As you can see, there's so much to do, something for everybody. We're not done. We've got a couple more days on the boat and another video coming your way.